Good evening and welcome to Metro Area Sports Wrap. I'm your host, Ryan Young. Cypress Hill, Black Sunday, check it out. Just released this past week. Make sure you pick up the single or the CD. It's definitely going on. Well, this week's show, we've got a great one coming up again. Each and every week we bring you great shows. How do we do it? How do we do it? It's because we have people who contribute to the shows like the following. John Thomas will be on today's show. Eric Nelson will talk his fantasy baseball. K-Fan still number one in the A division in fantasy baseball. And of course, Dave Carlson and Jeff Gould will be with us as we get into our weight training, and all you basketball players might learn a thing or two to help improve your game. That's all coming up. It starts with the scoreboard section, including Pro-Am coverage. So stay tuned. You're watching Metro Area Sports Wrap. Welcome back to the show. As you can see here, we're down here at a scenic location this week, Minneapolis right over my shoulders, NSP Hydro Plant right next door as well. Well, anyways, it's time for the scoreboard section. Into the scoreboard section we go. Topping this week's scoreboard section news, Herb Carneal, Twins announcer, had a successful heart surgery Thursday at Fairview Riverside Hospital. We brought you up to date with that last week. The surgery was to repair a valve that was malfunctioning. Herb is in his 31st season as the Twins play-by-play announcer, and good luck to Herb Carneal in his recovery. We look forward to seeing him in a booth. He's a legend in his own time. Since I've been born, I've been listening to him, and good luck, Herb Carneal. In basketball news, the University of Minnesota men's basketball team has received a tentative schedule for this year's television broadcast. Included are 5 regional and/or national broadcast games. They'll include the likes of St. John's, Rice, Indiana, Michigan. The university committee still has to verify this to make it all official, but it's nice to see the University of Minnesota finally getting the airtime and the props that it deserves. In other basketball news, Bob McCann, the Timberwolves, has signed an undisclosed deal with the Houston Rockets. Bob McCann, one of the smallest players, is 6'6", to play center for the Timberwolves, will take his great inside ability and work ethic down to Houston. I caught up with Bob McCann earlier this week to ask him his opinions of both playing for the Timberwolves and now going down to play for the Houston Rockets. This guy is bigger in person than he is on TV. Now, you're leaving the Minnesota Timberwolves to go down to Houston is what we were told tonight. Is that true?
Yes, that is true. I had an opportunity to go down to Houston, work out a couple of days, and you know, they made an offer, and after I passed the physical and everything, it'll be a done deal.
Could you elaborate a little bit about maybe your career as a Timberwolf and what the Timberwolves meant to you?
The Timberwolves always be a one of my best teams I ever played for. They gave me an opportunity to play. Jack said when I came here, he would give me an opportunity to get my NBA career started, and it's happened. So I'm sad that I'm leaving, but unfortunately I got a great opportunity to play here, so I can go on from here. Yeah.
Have you and Scott Brooks talked yet? Is he looking already designing some pass plays for you down there?
But not yet. A friend of mine knows him here, and I'm going to go down there and I'll see Scott this weekend sometime, and I'll be able to talk to him a little bit, but definitely talk to him about getting the ball.
Good luck to Bob McCann as him and ex-Wolves Scotty Brooks will now make a good teammate together. We'll see how many assists Scotty can throw to McCann for the big jams. In other basketball news, the Pro-Am game still taking place in downtown St. Paul this week. And once again, MASW was on the scene, and that's the focus of this week's Court Scenes.
Court Scenes, Bababua. Take a look at some of the action here as we get to the Court Scenes with the Boys Pro-Am. Representing Minneapolis, it was a fun time. Check them out in black, Northwest Airlines and Minneapolis City Conference Boys. Wasted no time, but wait, no, the team we saw last week, McDonald's Homestead, not ready to give up. Homestead, 8 points in the first 2.5 minutes. Homestead on a tear. Watch them light it up. So, would the streak continue? A newcomer, Paul Hill, Paul Hill's cousin, the coach, Paul Hill. His little cousin comes on and decides to play some ball. He lights it up, bars from outside for 3, and everything was falling in for McDonald's. It looked like Paul Hill filling in for the other coach might get his second victory 2 weeks in a row. But wait, Could Minneapolis come back? Mills tries. Homestead says no dice. And the break is on. McDonald's up by as many as 20. Could Minneapolis possibly come back? Could they see the light is the question. Well, time would tell. Time would tell. Time would tell. As the lights started to clear up and vision started to come, as Minneapolis as usual, Mills says, we're in this one. And then from downtown, Peters put the deuce off the glass. It wasn't wasting much time after that. Snidey outside for the threes, and it was time to exchange some three-pointers. As Minneapolis started to come to life, like usual, they just needed a couple seconds to warm up. Peters draining the three. Then Barr says, I can do it too, baby, knocking it down. Snidey from Roosevelt, booyah! And on their tear right there, 6 three-pointers in a row, 4 by Northwestern, 2. Look at Minnie with the monster block. Get that out of here then with the patent turnaround. Deuce! And Minneapolis was on their way. On the run they're going. Look at the handles. Boone. Look at the assist. Peters all night long, baby. All night long. Oh, off the mark. Yeah. Look at that. Nice ups by Minia. 2 in a row. Minia's getting to be a strong player down low. Watch out for him. He's a senior. But Homestead, nevertheless, look at the showtime, baby. Passing, passing. Fundamental basketball breaking down. 2 minutes left in the game. Close game. Then the pick. Peters, the defensive. That's the story of this one. The defensive pressure turned up. But nevertheless, Homestead says, we got a shot, baby. Boosh with the monster jam. Comes in, but nevertheless, Northwest Airlines pulls it off, coming up back from 20 at halftime for the victory, going to the line to sink it. Good, and Minneapolis walks away 5-0. Snidey, nice try. As we take a look at the scoreboard, McDonald's victorious last week over Coca-Cola. Can't beat Northwest Airlines, 83-78. Peters with 19, Minia 16, Hill 22, and Homestead 18.
I'm looking at the phone. Your microphone. If you mess with me, I'll break your bone. 3 years ago, a friend of mine asked me in the bus a vicious run. I told him try to get out of my face while I brush my eyes.
Well, is that smooth or what? Yeah, you know it is. Check it out. He was catching the vibes. K-Fan in purple. Coke in red. It was a game that was very exciting. You see there, John Thomas, one of the highly touted from Roosevelt, going to the U. Bob McCann over Ernest. Nigga Gonzabo. Excuse me, Ernest. I'll just call him Ernest. Scoring there. He looked very impressive, by the way. On the other end, John Thomas with the tip. Now watch the hops coming up, as Thomas has definitely been working those legs a lot this summer. He's going to be an exciting player to watch. But McMorris, unstoppable. Coke jumped out to a 24-point lead. Thomas did his best to keep his team and K-Fan in it. But Coke on fire. McMorris, one of the league leaders, averaging over 30 points in the league right now. And you're seeing why. Look at the dish for the reverse. Oh, K-Fan's on a roll, trying to come back from a 20-point lead. McCann with the turnaround. See how he's going to do in Houston. Then the little man, Hill, who coached in the game before, hits the J, coming down. Then the pass to McCann. Look at Hill. Look at McCann. That was a big lead. K-Fan needs to come back. Sampson, get out of here. Now the time comes down. Here comes McCann. Booyah! In your face. One more time as you take a look at it. McCann on his way to having a sensational first half. Coke up by as many as 25 again in this one. That was the story. John Thomas tries to keep him in it, and K-Fan tries to get on a run. A little lackadaisical defense, and the game starts to turn around. Look at that attempt. Ooh, nice try by John Thomas. Then K-Fan starts pouring it on. Ernest for the two. Oh, if he does that move next year, the Gophers will be sitting fat. McMorris, though. Oh, unstoppable. He knows how to put the ball into the hole. Now watch this pass play. Watch it develop. Ernest is growing. Look at his crossover. The dish. The two. Oh, could the Gophers be ranked in the top 10 next year? Then John Thomas. Look at this move, fellas. He's not even a freshman yet. He's not even a freshman. Taking it to the big guys. Then McMorris says, no, you don't. This game is ours. Drains the three. And that's basically how the story will be told. Sampson with his attempt and the dunk. Get out of here. K-Fan sends K-Fan to another loss. Coca-Cola victorious, 106-103. McMorris 34, McCann 22, Thomas 16. You see there the records is Coke 2-5, K-Fan 4-4. Now back from court scenes, back to the main man, Rye.
Well, an exciting time again over at the Salvation Armory. Make sure that you can mark on your calendar this date, July 30th, as it will be the date of the All-Star Celebrity Three-Point Slam Dunk Evening Contest. It all kicks off that evening at 7 o'clock at the Salvation Army. Make sure you come down there and check it out. The likes of some of the great NBA players from locally, as well as ex-Gophers, as well as future Gophers, and some of the players you just saw, as well as the celebrity game, Don Shelby and the WCCO crew versus the Minnesota Timberwolves head office slam dunk competition. Last year, Melvin Newbern won it. We'll see if he'll be in it, maybe trying to take the slam dunk contest again, so make sure you can check it out. In fantasy baseball news, the league standings now. All you people following the league standings, check it out. Here's how they shape up this week. K-Fan leads the league right now at 13-3. They're the hottest team by far. 460 total points. Coming in second in the A division, Sergeant Preston's 8-8. They're 5 games back with a total points of 398. Willie Insurance at 8-8, 5 games back at 383 points total. Albrecht 8-8, 5 games back with a 374 point total. So K-Fan's really running the division right now with the other teams grouping around that same stanza. As you move into the B division, it looks like if the B division should maybe take everybody but K-Fan, it might be even more interesting. Leading the B division still, General Managers Fantasy Baseball. They've been in control there for the last 2 weeks. Their 9-7 record, 363 total points. Super America, 6-10. 3 games behind with 416 total points. The second highest total points so far. Stremski Insurance at 6-10, 3 games back, 302 points. And Metro Area Sports Wrap Team, 5-11, 4 games back with 328 points. MASW still bringing up the rear, but some transactions taking place this week that maybe will put MASW back into the swing of things. Well, who's the producer? Who's putting up the big points? Check it out. Again, staying on top of the list are four names that we brought you last week. For Toronto Olerud, he's got 65 runs, 130 hits, and a 396 average. Galarraga for Colorado has a 44 runs, 112 hits, and a 377 average. Merced for Pittsburgh has 51 runs, 97 hits, and a 355 average. And Barry Bonds of San Francisco, 76 runs, 113 hits, and a 348 average. Well, pitching victories, you get 5 points for every pitching victory. Who are some of the top pitchers right now in the league? Well, for Chicago, McDowell's mopping them up at 14-6. Burkett for San Francisco at 13-4. Swift for San Francisco, two San Francisco pitchers making it there, 13-5. And Key for the New York Yankees, 12-3. Well, throw the league away move. There was a move this week, and we like to call it the Who's Blowing the League. Well, as usual, it's Metro Area Sports Wrap. Metro Area Sports Wrap listed Fred McGriff as their backup first baseman this week because of the recent slump by Fred McGriff, therefore instituting Crook as the number one starter. Well, because of his lack of production, McGriff has shown in the past. Now, as we all know, McGriff now with Atlanta. Well, since Fred McGriff has been with Atlanta, he has 3 homers in just his first 2 games, so Metro Area Sports Wrap has missed in excess of almost 11 points. Well, that should do it now for the scoreboard section. We're going to jump right into the show. When we come back, we'll start off with weight training. Then we'll talk with John Thomas and Eric Nelson. It's exciting. It's going to be a lot of fun. Stay tuned. You're watching Metro Area Sports Wrap.
I love hiking in a forest.
You know, Robin, forests are more than just great places to go hiking in.
They are?
Sure. Forests are homes to lots of different animals. We get wood from forests, and they help keep our air and water clean.
Gosh.
But our forests are threatened by development and people who don't treat them with respect.
Yeah.
To find out how you can help, write to Forests, National Wildlife Federation.
Washington, D.C., 20036.
How'd you know that address?
A Frog Scout's always prepared.
Welcome back to the show. It's hard to believe that there can be this much junk hanging out in the river. Hard to believe this river was once blue at one time. We need to get this cleaned up. Anyways, back to the show. Well, lately we've been bringing you up to date with a segment on weight training and weightlifting. We've been following Dave Carlson, who's trying to make that junior college team. Well, part of the reason for that is this, as my shoes get all wet. Part of the reason is because in the off season, basketball players are made. The off season, not during the season. It's in the off season when you can implement those skills, when you can gain the strength to help you during the regular season. Well, with that in mind, Dave's been on a 13-week training program, and we'll check in with him and see how his training program is doing as the weeks roll right along.
Basically, Dave does leg extensions for the purpose of strengthening his tendons and ligaments in his knee and around his knee. It helps, like, in season when it's not time to do squats and different exercises like that require a lot of weight. You just want to do leg extensions and leg curls for maintaining strength during the season. You don't want to lift heavy weights. You're tired and fatigued enough from practice. The reason he does leg curls is to equally strengthen his hamstrings along with his thighs. You don't want to have an imbalance there. You know, your hamstrings are 90% of your speed up and down the court and your lateral movement.
Yeah, it still work, because it's still, Jeff talked about my conditioning getting better, but you know, I know it's it can get a lot better. You know, I know I can still go higher and get into a groove and then go from there. I'm still working to a point, you know, getting comfortable. I don't think I'm there yet.
Okay, this exercise works your upper abdomen section. Basically, your power, your strength, you know, everything coordinates around your stomach. You know, you'll never find a basketball player who doesn't have a strong stomach. Right now, you're just mainly concentrating on your upper abs right in here. We'll do another exercise after this that concentrates on your lower abs down in here. Keep your breathing controlled and just tense the muscles. Good. You don't want to do a full sit-up. People still do full sit-ups these days. It's nothing but hurting your back. You want to concentrate on doing just a crunch. Good, keeping your back nice and flat and just raising up. This exercise definitely works.
Low fat. Low fat, it's not necessarily a high calorie diet or, you know, mega protein diet. It's a low fat, healthy diet that cuts out a lot of the sugars and a lot of the junk.
Basically, he's watching what he's eating.
Well, yeah, that's basically
and paying like, attention to the fat content of foods and everything like that. On a diet, I don't really recommend people dieting, especially if the average person eats normal. Main thing is just to watch what you eat. If you go out to a restaurant and instead of ordering, you know, a large fry, order a small fry or something. I mean, you can't change a person's nature. You know, you can't take a person who's used to drinking pop and everything and saying, okay, no more pop now. You know, you have to drink mineral water. You know, you have to slowly, you know, wean them off and everything like that. And that's where Dave is right now. He's just watching what he's eating.
I cut out pop. I went from the whole milk down to skim milk.
Skim milk, yeah.
I'm taking the supplements.
And see, little things like that really, really matter.
You know, a lot of chicken and rice and stuff like that.
Well, just the
a lot of vegetables.
Lesser fat content really helps in a diet.
Dave coming back after taking some time off to get himself together from the injury, recover from his hip injury. As you can see, his intensity's picked up where he left off, and good luck to him as he continues to work along that 13-week training program. I'll tell you what, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. When we come back to Metairie Sports Wrap, we found John Thomas, the star who's going to the University of Minnesota this year to play for Coach Clem Haskins, the basketball player from Roosevelt. Asked him a couple questions about how he's doing this summer. Stay tuned. That's right after this break. You're watching Metro Area Sports Wrap.
There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Welcome back to the show. Well, you see there, that was the Metro Area Sports Wrap official mode of transportation. you know, you can't pack all the homies on, but it gets you around. When it rains, I'm kind of bumming. In winter, I'll probably be real ill, but for right now, it gets by in the summer vibes and everything. Anyways, back to the show. I had an opportunity of meeting up with John Thomason, talking with him briefly at the Pro-Am games this past week. I wanted to ask him a couple questions about how the summer's going and how he's looking at the University of Minnesota next season. So we'll let you take a look at that as I sat down with John Thomas.
Mostly, I've been lifting weights, trying to get out and shoot, trying to get out and run a little bit, but mostly it is lifting weights.
You've been traveling around now, doing some traveling in the spring, going overseas is what I heard. Tell me about that experience and some of the things you learned from that.
Well, we went to Germany, and I was the only one out of Minnesota to go. We had a 12-man team, and we went, you know, we played against teams like Croatia, Lithuania, France, Italy, you know, teams throughout, you know, out over there in Europe and stuff like that. But it was cool because I did okay. At first I didn't really do too well, but towards the end it was like an all-star team and I didn't start. So it was like I wasn't really used to starting and my head really wasn't in it. But towards the end, you know, I'm like, okay, we gotta win the national championship. And we got together and last game I was MVP and we did win the national championship.
You've got a lot of talent. Your hops are starting to get up. How's the weightlifting going for you?
It's going pretty good. At first, I dreaded it, you know. I didn't want to go into weightlifting, but I knew it helped me. And I kept going in, and it's like I'm getting bigger and stronger, and I feel it, and it's like I'm addicted to it now.
Have you got any advice from fellow teammate Ernest Zigamazabo, possibly some of the other golfers who've been playing in this league as far as what to expect under Clem and in the system next year at the U?
Just that he's gonna enforce me, you know, he's gonna make me work hard. And that's what they said, just push yourself because, you know, if you don't, Clem will, so.
We talked last year and I asked you if you were ready, if you had that fire. You still have that fire inside for basketball and to play?
Yeah, I do.
Are you going to make an impact at the U, and are you going to make an impact for all our viewers out there?
Well, it all depends on how, you know, how hard I work. If I work hard enough, if I get down to low post moves, you know, because I feel my offense needs a little work, but I know the coaches will work with me on that one. You know, time will tell.
Okay, speaking here with John Thomas. He's going to be an exceptional player. If you have a chance to come check out the Pro-Am games, you're going to see him. You're going to see him trying to dunk. Hey, one last question. You missed that dunk. You're going to throw it in. You're going to make it up for us?
Of course.
Oh, yeah. All right, speaking with John Thomas from Roosevelt. Thanks, John.
Good luck, man. I'll talk to you. Okay.
Evidently, that young guy has seen his better days. Anyways, back to the show. John Thomas, very interesting conversation. You hear there some weight training. He's doing some different things. We look forward to seeing whether or not John Thomas will become redshirted or whether he won't be. I'll tell you, if he keeps to improve, it doesn't matter because in 3-4 years, John Thomas will be that big impact player that the university is looking for. Keep up the good work, John. Well, I got a chance to meet up with K-Fan. They're 10-3 right now, running the Fantasy Baseball League, driving the other general managers crazy. Everybody's in jealous. Everybody's in awe. I met up with Eric Nelson of K-Fan, and I sat down and had a conversation with him about his team. And that's the focus of this week's Fantasy Baseball Conversation Breakdown.
They say every dog has his day. I guess we're having our day. But I was joking with Larry the other day. I said, you and Dusty Baker are the leading candidates for Manager of the Year. Larry, I know he's impressive in terms of sports knowledge, but I didn't know he'd be able to draft a team this good. But I think he took advantage of some guys that stayed out there late. And when you get a Cecil Fielder to lead it off and a Barry Bonds and guys like that, I think you got a baseball team that's going to be among the best. Well, Barry Bonds is obviously the marquee guy. I know he hit his 27th home run, I think it was Thursday night. Giants are just playing great baseball. I think the strategy he went in with and that I told him and we discussed is let's try to make sure we get somebody off the teams that are doing well. And the Giants are just, they're dominant right now. And then Cecil Fielder, I mean, this guy is just, he's one of the best players, home run hitters, RBI guy, maybe in the history of baseball. He might win, what, four straight RBI titles. Then you look at a guy like Dean Palmer. We got him really late. And some of our other people, I mean, we got Chuck Knobloch, who started a little slowly, but he's capable of coming on. I like our team a lot, and again, Larry did a great job. No shock. In fact, the only shock here is that he didn't take Tony Kukoc and Bill Cartwright and Phil Jackson. Larry's Bulls, I tell you, he loves them with a passion. Actually, Michael, though, you might know this, Ryan. Michael was a pretty good high school baseball player, and he loved high school baseball and the sport as a kid. And, you know, he hit pretty well in the All-Star game last week in the celebrity competition. I know he's hit a home run at the old ballpark in Chicago. Michael might be a guy that, had he pursued baseball, he might be in the major leagues right now. He might be on one of the fantasy. Best advice I can give you is start preparing for next year. I think this juggernaut that we've assembled, and most of the credit goes to Larry because I was upstairs on the truck with you and Jeff giving the sideline commentary, if you will. I don't see our team cooling down. I don't see Barry Bonds letting up. I mean, this guy, he is the Michael Jordan of the major leagues. Cecil Fielder plays in a great, great home run park. I mean, what, it's the only park where 10,000 home runs have ever been hit, Tiger Stadium. So he's going to continue to hit home runs. Our team will win it. I guarantee it. And all I can say to the rest of the league is it'll be a nice battle for second. Well, I think if you look at pitching, and obviously pitching is something you address a little bit later in the draft, but when we have guys like Randy Johnson, Jose Rijo, we're not only going to get wins in most cases, we're going to get strikeouts. Jeff Russell out of the bullpen gives us strikeouts and saves. Rick Aguilera, one of the premier closers. I mean, I feel like our pitching staff in the pen, and as far as the starters go, is, you know, it's tough to beat in the league. I don't think any team can top us, maybe equal us, but not top us. And offensively, I mean, I can't tell you, you know, I had a dream the night before the draft, and in the dream, I said, man, I'd like to have Fielder, Bonds, Tettleton. I would love to have those guys all on one team, Dean Palmer, Canseco if he's healthy. Well, my dream came true. I mean, we got these guys on our roster, and even though Canseco's hurt, we're not going to see him this year. I mean, Fielder and Tettleton and Bonds, that's a 1-2-3 home run punch. The only thing we're missing is, say, a Juan Gonzalez, and we'd be perfect. I think offensively, our team is very good, and even though we have a lot of power, we still can get some speed thrown at you. Brian McCray is pretty good in the outfield, and he can steal some bases. We know about Bonds, and with that pitching staff, I really believe that it's going to be tough for somebody to catch us. I don't mean to sound arrogant or cocky. Things happen. Teams blow leads. But I feel good about our club. If we stay healthy and everybody plays up to capabilities like they have been. Jose wants to come back. There's no doubt. He's a little down right now. It was a dumb move by our manager to put him in there to pitch. I mean, that's why he's out right now. But, you know, we don't want to second guess or look back. The situation is this. He's hurt. We got to get him better. I just said, look, why don't you get in your red Lamborghini or Ferrari or whatever it is you drive, your Jaguar, and just take a little spin around the country and don't get any speeding tickets. That's all I said. You know, he likes to put the pedal to the metal, and when you got a red car, you're a target for the highway patrol. But Jose says he will be back. We'll be in camp next year down in Florida in late February, and he will be there, and he says he will be in as fit a shape as he's ever been in. So I really think, Ryan, that, you know, we got a good ball club. Attendance is up. We may draw $4 million. The only team ahead of us is the Rockies, and I'm excited about this club. Now, I could go on and on about our team, but my beeper's going off, and I've got a phone call that I've got to go take. In fact, it may be from another team in this league. People are asking me about Cecil Fielder, Mickey Tettleton, and Barry Bonds. They're not available, but I'll talk to anyone.
Welcome back to the show. Eric Nelson, yeah, I'm jealous. The truth is, I am jealous. They're 10-3, Metro Area Sports Wrap, respectively trying to crawl back in the race, though, with the advent of players like Bo Jackson picked up this past week. They're making some moves. We'll give K-Fan a run for their money. I, I'm confident in that. Well, anyways, it's been a great show. I'd like to thank you for tuning in to Metro Area Sports Wrap. Make sure you tune in each and every week as we're out here catching the vibes. Make sure you're catching the summer vibes. You got the graffiti instead of the city in the background, so we're going to step over here just a tad. Camera follow. Make sure you tune in next week. If you got anything you'd like to drop in the mail, don't hesitate to drop us a line here at Metro Area Sports Wrap in care of Minneapolis Television Network, 125 Southeast Main Street, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55414. Any information you send in, I guarantee we'll take a look at it. And if you send me tournament info or whatever it may be, maybe a little tidbit, maybe you've got something that you want me to know and you want me to break on the show, drop it to me. We'll put it in the scoreboard section. We'll work something out. Hey, for Metro Area Sports Wrap, the cast and crew, I'm Ryan Young. Thank you, and make sure you're out there catching the summer vibes. And have a good evening.